First, when Janelle James, who is the woman's development manager, came to me about the course, she said FIFA allowed them to have this for some of the former players and the present players to get them involved in coaching, and I was happy to be the one to conduct this course. In discussions this morning with CONCACAF, we have been doing these CONCACAF C license courses for the past 4 or 5 years, and they said to me, listen, if you're using the same syllabus, which I am using, and I'm using some additional work that we have done with TTFA over the past 10 years, and I'm bringing it together. They said they were able now to certify all the participants with CONCACAF license. I think this in itself is a big step forward. It's what we were hoping for. We thought it might have been a year or two away. It's upon us right now. And I'm really happy for these girls, because this course is going to entail information like leadership, which is going to help them not just leading themselves, but being able to lead players, being able to lead parents, being able to lead young ones. It's going to speak a lot about manage. How do they manage their own time? How do they manage their teams? How do they manage scheduling? It's going to speak a lot about teaching and coaching. It's going to speak a lot about preparation and planning. So this is the base course so that they're able to grow and hopefully in the near future do some of the more advanced courses. Yes, it's going to be safe, because thinking about it, other than conducting the CONCACAF courses, I was actually part of the design of the CONCACAF course, and we designed the C-license course a couple of years ago. Of course, it has been improved each time. We took directions directly from UEFA, so there's consistency between our confederation and other confederations. So we are really in a good place right now, and as I said, it's a great building block for our young persons. I've got a couple of people that they will be doing train the trainers. So they will be future coach educators. So we've got Rajesh Lachu, Marlon Charles, Paul Deckels. They're all coming in at different times. We have Desiree Sargent. She's not here because she's with one of the teams. Now, in saying that, it's a 2 to 3 year period of development to become a coach educator. And in FIFA, it's a 4 to 6 year period. So they're all logging hours, I guess like any other profession. So they're able to do parts and parcel of the course, and we will log the hours to make sure there's enough experience that day one they will be conducting these courses on their own. Tell you what, it's always good to get full points, because you're getting full points coming off of 2 games and you've got more games to play. You're able to see your strengths, areas you need to improve. You're able to see your opponents. So now you're in a better position to plan. So I think it's a blessing in disguise, regardless of the results, that you're now in a better position to move forward to the next games. You know, the only advice is we have to remember the other coaches also saw the same. They saw us and our potential, and we have to probably keep searching out players that have the interest to play for our country, no different to any of the other Caribbean islands or any of the other territories. So again, I wish both of them luck, and I'm so happy that they have joined our profession.